Dance. Let me see you move. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Dance. Let me see you move.
Mine, I've got to say, I want this to be mine personally now. My daughter made me a promise. I've got the promise. What I've got to do is go to the bank and say, would you please put that into my account? I want to confirm that it's mine. Now, in the Church of England, we have this two-stage process where a child is baptised, admitted into the church and fellowship with the church, and promises are made by God, by me, by you, to say, we'll do everything we can to hold this child in our care until the day when the child can make their own decision. And at that point, we call it confirmation. And Daniel might be 12, he might be 20, he might be 50. I had a lady of 72, three or four years ago, who got confirmed because she said, I think I understand now. So when he is old enough to understand, he can be confirmed. So the first part today is the receiving of the promises. And in time to come, is the promise becoming reality, as he says, I want to make it mine. My daughter's glad I never made the promise mine. I just kept the promise. And that can happen with an infant baptism if we just keep the promise and we don't ever get the reality. So that's what we hope will happen. So, here we go with the service of baptism. A child who's too young to profess the Christian faith is baptized on the understanding they're brought up as Christians within the family of the church. As Daniel grows up, he will need the help and encouragement of his family, so he learns to be faithful in public worship, private prayer, to live by trusting God, and to come one day to confirmation. Parents and godparents, family and friends, Daniel, whom you brought for baptism, will depend chiefly on you and the help and encouragement he needs. This is what you will give him by your prayers, by your example, and by your teaching. God is creator of all things, and by the birth of children, he gives parents a share in the work and joy of creation. But we who are born of earthly parents need to be born again. In the Gospel, Jesus tells us, unless a person has been born again, they cannot see the kingdom of God. And so God gives a way to a second birth, a new creation, and life in union with him. Baptism is a sign and seal of this hope. In St. Matthew's Gospel, we read of the risen Christ commanding his followers to make disciples of all nations and baptize people everywhere. St. Peter preached these words, "Repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of sins, and you'll receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. This promise is to you, to your children, and to all who are far off, everyone whom the Lord calls to him." In obedience to this command, we were baptized, and today we bring Daniel to baptism. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our baptism for life in Christ. We pray for Daniel. In your love, you called us to know you, led us to trust you, and bound our life with yours. Surround him with your love, protect him from evil, fill him with your Holy Spirit, and receive him into the family of your church, that he may walk with us in the way of Christ, and grow in the knowledge of your love. Amen. So, will parents and godparents understand what you are? Thank you. You'll need your service sheet. The rest of you can look on there because you can join in as well. Those who brought a child to be baptized must affirm their allegiance to Christ and their rejection of things that are evil. It's your duty to bring up Daniel to fight against things that are evil and to follow the way of Christ. So, bring on the sheet. Parents and godparents, family and friends, I ask you these questions which you answer for yourselves and also for Daniel. Do you turn to Christ? I turn to Christ. Do you repent of your sins? I repent of my sins. Do you renounce evil? I renounce evil. You brought Daniel to baptism, and you must now declare before God and the church the Christian faith into which you'll be baptized and which you'll help him to grow. You answer for yourselves and also for Daniel. So once again, we're on the sheet. Daniel Illiam, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. There we are. Tie you a bit. I sign you with the cross, the sign of Christ, and there are some words there for you to say. Do not be ashamed to confess the faith of Christ crucified. We all say, quite valiantly under the banner of Christ, against sin, the world, and the devil, and continue as his faithful soldier and servant. Daniel, receive this light. This is to show that you've passed from darkness to light. We all say, shine as a light in the world to the glory of God the Father. God receive you by baptism into his church. We welcome you into the Lord's family. We are members together of the body of Christ. We are children of the same Heavenly Father. We are inheritors together of the kingdom of God. We welcome you. Lord God, our Father, maker of heaven and earth, we thank you that by your Holy Spirit, Daniel has been adopted as your own and received into the fellowship of your church. Grant that he may grow in the faith in which he's been baptized, that he may come to profess it for himself when he's confirmed, and that all things belonging to the Spirit may live and grow in him. Amen. Heavenly Father, we pray for Simon and Gaynor, give them the spirit of wisdom and love, that their home may reflect the joy of your eternal kingdom. Amen. Say together the Lord's Prayer, the Our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Amen. Bless you.
On the top, it's all right, 'cause I know that you love me. I'm laying in bed with a whole lot of wonder going through my head. This doggy buffer gets a little bit lonely. I'm too cool to lose my control. You're too cool to call. Maybe I just don't wanna know. You're out there having it all.
Baby, come home to me.
Without me, I just can't let you start it.